من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to Dore Quran English class. We are doing juz number 14. Let's begin our session. In this juz, we're going to cover Surah Al-Hijr and Surah Al-Nahl. Alif Lam Ra, tilka ayatul kitabi wa Qur'an mubin. So this surah starts with Huruf-e-Muqaddad. Huruf-e-Muqaddad are the letters which the meaning only Allah subhanallah ta'ala knows about it. Alif Lam Ra, these are the verses of the book and the clear book. So here Allah subhanallah ta'ala talks about the Qur'an. Before going further, Allah subhanallah ta'ala says in Qur'an, innahu la Qur'anun kareem. Surah Al-Waqiyah, ayah number 77, that indeed is a noble Quran, meaning the Quran is very noble, it is very honorable, it is very respectable. And the Mufassirun say that the word Kareem, which is generally translated as noble, is a comprehensive word which describes something that is being praised. And the Quran is Kareem because it contains what is worldly, worthy of praise. So Quran is worthy of praise, that's what it means. So here Quran is a guidance, so the people of understanding, they make evidence from the Quran, they derive rulings from the Quran, people who are wise. So this was about the Quran, and let's begin our today's juz. And here it starts with Alif Lam Ra, and this is the verses which are called Huruf-e-Muqaddad. Only Allah knows the meaning. These are the verses of the book and the clear Quran. Perhaps those who disbelieve will wish that they had been Muslims. Now, the actually surah starts in the previous juz, but this juz starts with Rubama yawuddul lazina kafaru law kanu muslimin. Like, you know, they are doing hasra. Like, perhaps those who disbelieve, we will wish if they were Muslims. This is the, you know, they wish for. Like they might have been Muslims. Let them eat and enjoy themselves and be diverted false hope, for they are going to know. In ayah number 3 means zarhum ya'kulu wa yatamattau wa yulhihumul amalu fasawfa ya'lamun. Leave them to eat and enjoy and let the false hope distract them, and soon they will come to know. So here talking about how people are deluded, and soon they will come to know. And here in the following ayah, we see that two threats are given over here. Zarhum mean that, first of all, leave them, let them be. And then second threaten is fasawfa yalamun, soon they will know. Ya kuluna yatamattau wa yulhihumul amal. And it is their eating, they're enjoying themselves and their long hopes, meaning they are too preoccupied with the present life. And we learn that if the son of Adam had a valley of gold, he would like to have two more valleys. And we learn that in a hadith that heart of an old man remains young in two respects, his love for the world and his also incessant hope, meaning his amal. So when a person has such expectation of the world, amal meaning incessant desire, then Al-Hasan al-Basri said that the servant never extend his worldly wishes except that his action become corrupt. So when a person make this world his ultimate concern and he just want more and more and more over here, then such expectation and hopes and desire make them forgetful of the hereafter. That's what it means. Like, you know, people, they are engrossed in such a kind and they forget hereafter. That's what it means. And let's continue. And we will not destroy. وَمَا أَحْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ إِلَّا وَلَهَا كِتَابٌ مَعْلُومٌ. And we did not destroy a city, but that for it was known decree. And ayah number 5 onwards, no nation will proceed its term, nor will they remain thereafter. And they say, O you upon whom the message, meaning the Quran, has been sent down, indeed you are a mad. Always they were blaming to prophets or Rasul. Why do you not bring the angels? They are asking for more miracles. If you should be among the truthful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds in ayah number 8. مَا نُنَزِّلُ مَلَائِكَةَ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَمَا كَانُوا إِذَا مُنْزَرِينَ. We do not send down the angels except with truth, and the disbelievers would be not then be reprieved. Meaning, then they won't have any more extended time. Means this is the time. And إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا ذِكْرُ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Indeed, it is we who send down the Quran, and indeed we will be its guardian. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Hafiz, meaning the guardian, the preserver of the Quran. So in Suratul Maida we learn Bima istahfizu min kitabillah, ayah number 44. They were entrusted with the book of Allah. So Allah will preserve. And we learn in Hadith, in one night the Quran will be taken away. So not even a single verse of the Quran will be left on earth. So it is necessary that we benefit from the Quran today. We learn it, memorize it, we teach it to our children. Yani this should be a part of our family. So we should memorize and adhere to it. And surely we sent messengers before you among the sects of the former, and no messengers would come to them except they ridicule him. Thus do we insert denial into the hearts of the criminal. They will not believe in it while there has already occurred the precedent of the former people. And even if we open to them gate from the heaven and they continue their ascent, like they keep on doing the wrong, they would say our eyes have only been dazzled. Rather, we are people affected by magic. Ayah number 16, we are doing Suratul Hijr. And we have placed within the heavens great stars, and we have beautified it for the observer. Ayah number 17 and 18, and we have protected it from every devil expelled, except the one who steals a hearing. And here in this mention, and persuade by a clear burning flame, ayah number 19, meaning the shaitan, the devils, they actually go up into the sky in order to listen to the conversation of the angels. Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give certain commands to the angel, then angels, they discuss them among themselves. Because when the command are being given, angels are overcome by the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayah number 19 and 20, and the earth we have spread it and cast therein firmly set mountains caused to grow. There's something of very well balanced thing. Ayah number 20 and 21, and we have made for you threaten therein means of living. We have made for you therein means of living for those whom you are providers. And there is not a thing but that as our depositors. وَمَا نُنَزِّلُ إِلَّا بِقَدْرٍ مَعْلُومٍ. And we send down not, we do not send it down except according to a known measure. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent according to the known measure. Ayah number 22 onwards. And we have sent the fertilization winds and sent down water from the sky and give you drink from it, and you are not the retainers. 23 and 24. إِنَّا لَنَحْنُ نُحْيِي وَنُمِيتُ وَنَحْنُ الْبَارِسُونَ. And indeed it is He, we who give life and cause death, and we are the inheritors. Ayah number 24 and 25, and we have already known the preceding generation among you. We have already known the later ones to come, and indeed your Lord will gather them. And indeed He is wise and knowing. And we did certainly create man out of clay from an altered black mud. And the jinn we created before from scorching fire. Ayah number 28. And mention when your Lord said to the angels, I will create a human being out of clay from an altered black mud. And when I proportionate him and breathe into him, my created soul, wa nafaqtu fihi min ruhi. Then what should you do? Then fall down into sajda, means prostration. So here talking about, you know, we see that ruh, that we have the soul, that is from who? This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayah number 30 onwards. through the angels prostrate, all of them entirely except Iblis. Abba, he refused to be with those who prostrate. So the incident of Adam al-Islam will be mentioned 7 times in the Quran. Allah said, O Iblis, what is the matter with you that you are not with those who prostrate? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him. He said, never would I prostrate to a human whom you created out of clay from an altered black mud. So he is giving a reason because, you know, Iblis belittle human being because of the origin of human being. So he is belittling the, you know, origin of human being. And later on he say, ayah number 34, then get out of here, for indeed you are expelled. And indeed upon him is the curse until the day of recompense. So now the Iblis has been cursed, and it was till the day of recompense he has given the time. We are doing Surah Al-Hijr, juz number 14. And the time it was given, like, you know, just imagine, Iblis has so much experience. So he make people, you know, instigate, do the waswasa. He said, my Lord, then reprieve me until the day they resurrected. Allah said, so indeed you are those who are reprieved. So Allah gave the time. Okay, that's fine. Until the day of time, well known. Ayah number 38 and 39. Qala Rabbi bima aghwaytani. He blamed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, my Lord, because you have put me in error, I will surely make disobedience attractive to them on earth. I will mislead them all. He was blaming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was challenging that he gonna mislead the people. But there are exception here. Except among your chosen servants, illa ibadaka minhum al-mukhlasin. You see, mukhlas is the thing which is pure from any mixture. Pure. So he, Iblis can't do anything who has ikhlas, who has purity, sincerity in yourself for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayah number 41 onwards, Surah Al-Hijr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is a path of return to me. That is straight indeed, my servants, no authority. So now Iblis is talking about, like, you know, he gonna instigate the people. Indeed, my servants, no authority will you have over them except those who follow of the deviators. You know, those who are righteous, he's not able to misguide them. And I am number 43 and 44, Surah Al-Hijr, and indeed, hell is the promised place for them all. It has 7 gates. For every gate is of them a portion designated. What are the 7 gates here talking about in ayah number 44? 7 gates of the hellfire. And innal muttaqin. Now talking about the righteous people. Indeed, the righteous will be within the gardens and springs, having told enter in peace, safe and secure. Ayah number 46 and 47. We will remove whatever is in their chest of resentment. Means Allah will remove the resentment. We learn in a hadith that the believers, after being saved from the hellfire, meaning after crossing the bridge over hell, they will be stopped at another bridge before Jannah. And this is called Al-Kantara. The name of that place is called Al-Kantara. Over there, mutual retaliation will be established among the people of Jannah. Meaning, before they enter Jannah, there will be qisas. And what is that qisas? That if someone has hurt another, then they will have to make up for it. So that justice will be established, and then their hearts will be cleansed and purified. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when they are cleansed and completely purified, then they will admit to Jannah. Ayah number 48, no fatigue will touch them, nor it will they ever be removed. So here, ayah number 49 onwards, if you have problem reconnecting in the Zoom, you can go on YouTube too, because it's live streaming on YouTube also. You can go to, like, Ilm Quran for All Bayan. If you subscribe that, there you can see Afrin Fatima Binte Sajida. If you go on that channel, you can see the live streaming is going on. Because some people, they have problem in connecting to the Zoom. If you are okay on Zoom, that's fine. So now ayah number 49, inform, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to my slaves. And inform my servants that is... it is I who am the forgiving and merciful. And ayah number 50, and it talks about, and that is my punishment, which is painful punishment. In Surah Al-Hijr, you will notice that it has very smaller ayahs. So Allah forgive, therefore rejoice, and He also punish, therefore fear. That is why we should neither despair nor become fearless. We learn that once Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came to some of the companions that they were laughing. So he said, by the one in whose hand is my soul, if you know what I know, you would laugh a little and cry more. Then he left. So people began to cry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to his messenger that, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why do you put my servants in despair? So he went back to the companions. He told them, receive good news, do good deeds properly, sincerely and moderately. Ayah number 51 onwards, وَنَبِّئْهُمْ عَنْ ضَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. And now talking about Ibrahim al-Islam's guest, inform them about the guest of Ibrahim al-Islam. Ayah number 52, when they entered upon him and said, peace Ibrahim al-Islam, indeed we are fearful to you. Like they did the salam, the angel said, fear not, indeed we give you good tidings of a learned boy. So like all of a sudden angels came and they said, don't fear. We learned earlier that when Ibrahim al-Islam served them food and they refused to eat it, that is when Ibrahim al-Islam felt very scared. So then the angels told him that we are the angels of your Lord and we have come to give you good news of the birth of a child. That child is going to be alim, knowledgeable and learned. And ayah number 54 onwards, he said, have you given me good tidings, although I am very old age person has came upon me, and then of what wonder do you inform? So he was thinking, he was astonished and amazed. Qalu basharnaka bilhaq. They said, we have given you good tidings in truth. So do not be of the despairing. So, and we see over there that sometimes even the most believing, sincere servants need reassurance. Ibrahim al-Islam had not despaired of Allah's mercy, but he indeed reassurance. Ayah number 56, Surah Al-Hijr. So he said, he who despairs of the mercy of the Lord, except for those who are astray. Ayah number 57, Ibrahim said, what is your business here, O messenger? So he, after giving the good news, he's asking, what is it? You know, what is the thing you came over here? They said, indeed, we have been sent to the people of the criminal. Here they are talking about Lut al-Islam, except the family of Lut. Indeed, we will save them all. So he's not just like, you know, he got the good news and he's happy. He's not concerned about others. No, he's concerned about others. And he was informed, except his wife, Allah decreed that she is of those who remained behind. And when the messengers came to the family of Lut, and he said, indeed, you are people unknown. We see that neither Ibrahim al-Islam or Lut al-Islam recognized the angels. Why? Because they don't have the knowledge of ghaib, unseen. They said, but we have come to you with that about which they were disputing it. Meaning you people didn't believe that the punishment would come. So they were disputing regarding that matter. And we have come to you with the truth. And indeed we are truthful. And set out with your family during a portion of the night and to follow behind them. You know, meaning Prophet of Allah, Lut al-Islam, should walk at the back and his family should be in front of them. And let not anyone among you look back, continue unto where you are commanded. So you see, it's mentioned here, once you left, then none of you should look back. So these are the instructions were given. And also we notice every time when Lut al-Islam is mentioned, his wife is mentioned, because wife betray in related to the deen, Islam. And because of that, Allah gave punishment to the wife of Lut al-Islam. And after that, in ayah number 66 onwards, and we conveyed to him the decree of that matter, those sinners would be eliminated by early morning, and the people of the city came rejoicing. Lut al-Islam said, indeed, these are my guests, so do not shame me. Because, you know, he was so scared because they are homosexual. They can do bad things with the angels. So he was so scared and concerned for the angels. Oh, Lut al-Islam, and fear Allah, do not disgrace me. So Lut al-Islam is saying, please do not do this, because the men, they wanted to have, like, you know, sex with these angels. And ayah number 70 onwards, they said, have we not forbidden you from protecting people? And then ayah number 71 onwards, Lut al-Islam said, these are my daughters. Meaning, don't think this thing in a wrong way, because he meant to say lawfully get married to my daughter. That's what it meant. It doesn't mean like, you know, people must be thinking they can have the open relationship, indecent things. No, not that way. By your life, indeed, they were in the intoxication, wandering blindly. Means intoxication means, you know, when you do haram, when you do incorrect things, you know, you will be like as if you are intoxication. And wandering blindly means because of the lust, you know, because of the uncontrollable desires. That's what it means. So shriek sees them at sunrise, and we made the highest part of the city its lowest, and rained upon them stones of the hard clay because of the crime they were doing. Indeed, in that are the signs for those who discern. And indeed, those cities are situated on an established road. Indeed, that is a sign for the believers, and the companions of the thicket were also wrongdoers. So we took retribution from them. Indeed, both cities are on clear highway, and we took retribution from them. And indeed, both cities are clear highway, and certainly did the companions of the Samud. One nation after another, they used to carve from the mountains houses, feeling secure, but the shriek seized them in the early morning. One after another nation, prophets has been sent, and they have been warned, but if they don't listen, they have been destroyed completely. So nothing availed them from what they used to earn. And ayah number 85 onwards, and we have not created heaven and earth and that between them except in truth. And indeed the hour is coming, so forgive with the gracious forgiveness. And inna rabbaka huwa khallaqul alim. And indeed your Lord, he is knowing, creator. And we have certainly given you, O Prophet, seven of the often repeated of the great Quran. In ayah number 87 here, walaqad ataina sab'an minal masani wa Quran al-azim, which talks about Suratul Fatiha. And also in Surah Yunus, it says, "Huwa khayrum mimma yajmaun." What we are collecting, it is best. What is best? Quran. And ayah number 88, do not extend your eyes forward or your toward by which we have given enjoyment to certain categories of the disbelievers. And here we learn, like, you know, one nation after another, how they were destroyed. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, are you amazed at this? So the companion said, yes. He said, the hand kerchiefs of Saad ibn Masud in Jannah are better than this handkerchief that Saad Muaz is given in Jannah. That is the way, better than the silk you are admiring. Yani, if men's are not allowed silk in this world, but they are allowed in the hereafter. That's what it mentioned. And we learned that Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu was once planting the sapling, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came by and he said, oh Abu Huraira, what are you planting? And he said, I plant for me, yani, a sapling, so that it can grow into a tree and I can benefit from it. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, shall I not tell you of a plant that is better than this? He said, of course, Allah's Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, say subhanallah wa bihamdihi wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. So zikr is always appreciated, so keep your tongue moist with the zikr. Allah loves the zikr. So whenever you are ideal, you are sitting, especially at the time of the Ramadan, make it a habit and say, indeed, I am a clear warner. Just we had revealed scripture to the separator, and who have made the Quran into portions. So your Lord, we will surely question them all about what they used to do. Then declare what you are commanded and turn away from the polytheists. Indeed, we are sufficient for you against the mockers who make equal with Allah another deity, but they are going to know. And here in this ayah it is mentioned, and we already know that your chest is constrained by what they say in ayah number 97. Walaqad na'lamu annaka yadiqu sadruka bima yaqulun. It constricts the chest, because sometimes when people hurt you, how you feel it. That's what fasabbi bihamdi rabbika wa kum minas sajidin. So glorify, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So first of all, do tasbih, like exalt Allah, praising Allah. And secondly, be of those who prostrate to Him, means doing the sajda. So first of all, do tasbih means in Surah Ar-Ra'd, it's mentioned Allah, بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَتْمَئِنَ قُلُوبٍ in ayah number 28. With the zikr of Allah, what happens? Your heart has the contentment and peace. Yani you feel very nice and tranquility and peace. And in secondly, كُلُّ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ, but those who make sajda to Allah, meaning pray together and do like fard salah, nafil salah, so they also feel nice. You know, sajda means prayer, and prayer will stop from very indecent acts, wrong things. Once like a sahaba said, you know, a person, he prays and he also steals. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yani if he keeps on praying, one day he will stop stealing. So in Surah Al-Ankabut, it is mentioned that, you know, then who prays regularly, it will stop from indecent act and wrong things. We should adhere with it, you know, praying, doing the fard, and also nafil. Like what I'm talking about, like, you know, during Ramadan, try to do qiyam also, like wake up early, like do the suhoor, which is called sehri, pre-dawn meal. And also do nawafil, like you can do tutu and do the tahajjud prayer. And you can listen my lectures on Welcome Ramadan and how the Ramadan you should spend. Inshallah, I'll share in the group also. Another surah we start, Suratul Nahl. Nahl means honeybee. Suratul Nahl is also a Suratul Naim, means Surat of blessing, because many blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are mentioned in this surah. Remember that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned His blessing to us, it is to help us those blessing and recognize them, because only when a person recognize blessing and recognize the giver of the blessing, we understand. So it's a part of our perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like, you know, praising Allah and realizing the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ata amrullahi fala tasta'jilu subhanahu wa ta'ala amma yushrikun. So the surah starts with the command of Allah is coming to be not impatient for it. Exalted is He, high above what they associate in Him. Means the command of Allah is coming. The day of judgment is coming. So be not impatient, because everything is a set time. And remember, no situation in His life is permanent. It will change, but how we respond to it, what remains permanent. And then in ayah number 2, Allah says He sends down the angels with the inspiration of His command upon whom He wills, of His servants, telling them, warn that there is no deity except Me, so fear Me. We see that in Suratul Naim, Suratul Blessing, like Surah Nahl, the first blessing that is mentioned here is the revelation of the Quran, the fact that Allah sends inspiration on the prophets. That is the thing mentioned here. Ayah number 3 onwards, Khalqa samawati wal ard, He created heaven and earth in truth. High is He above what they associate in Him. Ayah number 4, He created man from a sperm drop. Then at once He created adversary. Ayah number 5 and 6, and the grazing livestock He has created for you, O humans. In them is a vomit, means from their skin and fur you use it. And numerous benefits, means food and clothing, and from them you eat. So we see that there, that blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like He mentioning, like, you know, how you take care of the blessings from the animals. And then mention, and for you in them is the enjoyment of beauty when you bring them from evening and when you send them out to pasture. Meaning, When you see livestock, when you take them out in the morning, when you bring them back in the evening, that's what it means. Like, you know, have you seen the scene, how they come and go? It looks very beautiful. And they carry your loads to a land you could not have reached except with difficulty to yourself. Indeed, your Lord is kind and merciful. Means, you know, some places you can't take your car or vehicle, you know, but animals you can mount upon and you can go anywhere. That's what it mentioned over here. Ayah number 8, Surah An-Nahl, he created the horse, mules, donkeys for you to ride as adornment. When you look at them, it's so adorable, especially the horses. He created that which you do not know. Like, there are so many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. We learn that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ride on these animals, then they are healthy. Leave them healthy also. Meaning, don't use them to point that they are emaciated and they are completely destroyed. You understand, like, you know, some people, they put so much load on the animals or they misuse the animals, you know. They punish the animals. Don't do such kind of things. That's what it means. Ayah number 9 and 10. And upon Allah is the direction of the right, and among the various paths are those deviating, that if He will, He could not have guided you all. And He who sends down rain from the sky, from it is drink, and from it is foliage in which you pasture animals. You know, everything depends on rain. He causes to grow for you thereby crops, olives, palm trees, grapevines, from all the fruits. Indeed, in that is a sign for the people who give thought. Ayah number 12 onwards, we are doing Surah An-Nahl, and we have subjected for you the night and day and the sun and the moon and the stars. All are subjected by His command. Indeed, in that are signs for a people who reason. So the whole galaxy, all the things are mentioned. Ayah number 13 onwards, and He has subjugated whatever is multiplied for you on earth of varying colors. Indeed, in that is a sign for the people who remember, you know, different colors, how earth is. And He who subjugated the sea for you and eat from tender meals. You know what we eat from the sea, fish and so on. And to extract from its ornaments which you wear, means pearls. And you see the ships plowing through it, and He subjected it that you may seek of His bounty. Means you are able to travel from one place to another. You know how you go in the boat, and perhaps you will be grateful. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. All the blessings one after another. And He has cast into the earth firmly set mountain, lest it shift with you, and made rivers and roads that you may be guided, and landmarks by the stars, they are also guided. You know, any dark night, if you go out for the walk, you will see, even in the backyard, if you see in the dark night, you can still see the path because of the stars. Ayah number 17 and 18, then is He who creates like one who does not create? So will you not remind it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, I am the one who creates and the other who does not create. Is it equal? أَفَمَنْ يَخْلُقُ كَمَنْ لَا يَخْلُقُ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Will you then not remember? Will you not remind it? Don't you use your intellect? And Ayah number 18, if you should count the favors of Allah, you could not enumerate them. Can we? We can't, right? And here, Ayah number 19 and 20, Allah says, indeed Allah is forgiving and merciful, and Allah knows what you conceal, what you decree. وَالَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. And those they invoke other than Allah, they created nothing, they themselves are created. And now talking about, they are in fact dead, not alive. They do not perceive when they will be resurrected. And here in Ayah number 22 and 22 to 24, your God is one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again saying, ilahukum ilahum wahid. You believe in only one Allah. But those who do not believe in the hereafter, their hearts are disapproving and they are arrogant. Assuredly, Allah knows what they conceal and what they declare. Indeed, He does not like the arrogant. Allah does not like the arrogant people. And what it is said to them, what has your Lord sent down? They say, legends of the former people. Yani they don't want to believe, just they are making up the things. If somebody don't want to believe, they won't believe that they may bear their own burdens in the full on the day of judgment, and some of the burdens of those whom they misguide without knowledge. Why? Because the person who calls others to error will have to carry the burden of themselves and also others. So you have to be careful when, with whom you are making friendship, with whom you spend the time, because you have to bear the burden of your own sins. Nobody else will bear the burden. If somebody is misguiding, it's their misguidance, it's their error. Don't get carried away. And then ayah number 26, those before them had already plotted, but Allah came at their building from the foundation, so the roof fell from the above them, and the punishment came to them from where they did not even perceive. 27 and 28, then on the day of resurrection, he will disgrace them and say, where are my partners from whom you used to oppose the believers? Those were given knowledge will say, indeed, disgrace this day and evil are upon the disbelievers. You know, Allah will say, okay, you were saying so and so partner, where are they? And are they going to help you or anything? So nobody is going to help them, right? So that's what it mentioned over here. Ayah number 28, we are doing Surah An-Nahl. And the one whom the angels taken in death while wronging themselves, and who then offer submission. And ayah number 28 and 29, so they offer submission saying, we were not doing any evil, but yes, indeed, Allah is knowing of what you used to do. Allah says, so enter the gates of hell, Allahu Akbar, to abide eternally therein. How wretched is the residence of the arrogant. How wretched. Remember, we see in this ayahs that the punishment for a criminal begins from the moment of the death onwards. This is mentioned in the hadith that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, when the angels come to take the soul of an evil person, they say, come out, O pure soul, that inhabitant and impure body, come out, blameworthy, and congratulations, because you will be receiving boiling water and purulent matter, other forms of punishment, means the excretion of the wounds. And this is continued to be said until the soul leaves the body. So remember, death is not termination. It is not resting. No, this is now the beginning of new life. Either you will be in punishment, either the window of Jannah will be open or window of the hellfire will be open. But depends on your deeds. The angel of death, when it comes, whether it brings good news of the Jannah or the bad news of the hellfire. Because on the day of judgment, that will be established. But till the time of day of judgment, you will be sleeping in the grave towards right or left. Right will be good news, like, you know, in Jannah, and you won't have any punishment of the grave. But the left, you will have the punishment of the grave. So you should make dua for the to save you from the punishment of grave, and daily recite Suratul Mulk to save from the punishment of the grave. That is an authentic narration. Ayah number 30. And you know, you can plan for the Ramadan time, especially those who memorize. If you are intention to memorize good surahs, make it a habit, because it has only 30 ayahs and we got 30 days. So it's easy to memorize it. Make a intention to memorize it. Allah will make it easy for you. And it will be said to those who fear Allah, what did your Lord send down? They say that which is good for those who do good in this world is good, and the home of the hereafter is better. How excellent is the home of the righteous. And ayah number 31, gardens of perpetual residence, which they will enter, beneath which rivers flow, they will have their whatever they wish. Thus Allah reward the righteous. So those who are righteous, kazalika yajzillahul muttaqeen, we have to have the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one whom the angels take in death, being good and pure, the angel will say, peace be upon you, enter Jannah for what you used to do. So here, entering the Jannah, but bima kuntum tamalun. Tamalun is from amal, like, you know, they actually tried, they did something. And there is a narration we learn that a righteous person, when angel of death comes to him, they say, come out so and so, welcome, O good soul that lived in a good body, enter praiseworthy and receive the good news of mercy, fragrance, and a Lord who is not angry. And this is continued to be said until the soul leaves the body. In the Quran, we learn that Suratul Fajr, ayah number 27 to 30, the good news is given at the time of death, and the reward begins from the moment onwards, and this will be perfected with and in the garden of perpetual residence. So all depends on your deeds. And Suratul Fussilat, ayah number 31, you will have in Jannah whatever that your soul desire. So walakum fiha ma tashtahi anfusukum, like whatever we desire, you know, just we think about it, Allah will give us. You will have in Jannah whatever that you ask for. In another hadith, we learn that one of the people of Jannah will ask Allah to allow him to farm, to cultivate the land. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him, are you not living in the pleasure that you like? Meaning, why do you need to have plants and agriculture? Why don't you everything that you need? He will say, yes, but I like to farm. I like to cultivate the land. So they will be given that preference. In another hadith, we learned that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when a person will be allowed, he will sow the seeds, plants will grow and become ripe, ready for picking, and so on, until they will be as huge as mountain within a moment. You understand, within moment, like, you know, we desperately wait for springtime, then we put the seed and then it will grow gradually. Yani, this will grow like in few moments. We learn that when a believer will want a child in Jannah, he will have the child conceived, grow up in a short while according to his desire. So in Jannah, everything is quick and easy, spontaneous, whatever you desire for. But you have to try hard. You have to work hard in this world. Then only you can get the Jannah. Do the disbelievers await anything except that the angel should come to them, or they come to the command of your Lord? Thus did those do before them, and Allah wronged them not, but they had been wronged themselves. Ayah number 34. So they were stuck by the evil consequence of what they did and were enveloped by what they used to ridicule. And ayah number 35, Suratul Nahl, and those who associate others with Allah say, if Allah had willed, we would not have worshipped anything other than Him, neither we nor our forefathers, nor would we have forbidden anything to other than Him. Thus did those do before them. So is there upon the messenger except the duty of clear notification? They are blaming to others. They themselves are not believing. And we certainly sent into every nation a messenger saying, worship Allah and avoid Taghut. Among them were those whom Allah guided. Taghut means false things. Like, you know, some people wear something and they say it's a good luck charm, bad luck, or particular thing, particular time. All those are Taghut. And among them were there upon whom error was decreed. So proceed through the earth and observe how was the end of the denial. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the warning. Look at around, you know, how I destroyed the people who are the deniers. Even if you should strive for the guidance, indeed Allah does not guide those who He sends astray. They will have no helpers. And in following ayah 38, and they swear by Allah, their strongest oath, that Allah will not resurrect one who dies. But it is a true promise. But Allah says, no, I will prove a true promise binding upon him. But most of the people do not know. 39 and 40. It is so He will make clear to them the truth of that where they differ. So those who have disbelief may know that they were liars. And ayah number 40. Indeed, our word to a thing when we intend it is but, that we say it to be, and it will be kun fayakun. That's it. Allah make it. And those who emigrated in the cause of Allah after they had been wrong, we will surely settle them in the world in a good place. And the reward of the hereafter is greater if only they could know. So if you're like, you know, traveling and going through one place to another for the sake of Allah, that is mentioned. They are those who endured patiently, and upon their Lord they relied. You know, patience, sabr is a must to be successful. And we sent not before you except men to whom we received our message. So ask the people of the message if you do not know. Ayah number 44, Surah Al-Nahl. We send them with clear proofs and written ordinance, and we reveal to you the message. Meaning, O Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we have revealed Quran for you, that you may take clear to the people what was sent down to them, and they might have thought. So this Quran is a clear. There's a narration. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, when it has something to do with your worldly affairs, you know best about it. But when it is the matter of religion, then refer it to me. Ayah number 45. Then do those who have planned evil deeds feel secure that Allah will not cause the earth to swallow them, or that punishment will not come upon them from where they do not even perceive? Like, you know, they are plotting and planning against the prophets. That's what it means. Or that he would not seize them during their usual activities. They could not cause failure, because Allah's Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam know by through the revelation wahi. Or that he would not seize them gradually in a state of dread, or that he would not seize them gradually, but indeed your Lord is kind and merciful. In ayah number 47, La Ra'ufur Rahim, and we learn, like, we should make dua. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min zawali ni'matika wa tahul afiyatika wa fujai ni'matika wa jamia saqatika. That, O Allah, I seek your protection from the decline of your blessing, and seek your refuge that your protection for me changed, and suddenness of your punishment. You know, change and sudden thing make you grieve sometimes, and all that which displeases you. Ayah number 48 onwards, have they not considered what things Allah has created? Their shadows inclined to the right and to the left, prostrating to Allah while they humble, and to Allah prostrate whatever is in heaven, on earth, creatures and angels. They are not arrogant. Everything is prostrating, and but they are not arrogant. Ayah number 50 onwards, they fear their Lord above them, and they do what they are commanded. And Allah has said, do not take for yourself two deities. And when sajda comes, when you are doing tilawa, recitation of the Quran, you have to do sajda tilawa where you are sitting. You can do there also, but if you want to do in direction of the qibla, that is really most liked. But what if sometimes you are reading the Quran, maybe you are in the train, maybe you are going in some vehicle, and you are not able to, you can do that moment of time in whatever direction you are. But here we are doing running translation. If you don't do the sajda, that also okay. But when you are reciting recitation, and you can say Subhana Rabbi al-Ala, but also there is a dua for the sajda, you can recite that also. And Allah has said, do not take for yourself two deities, and to him belongs whatever in heaven and earth, and to him is due worship constantly. Then it is other than Allah what you fear, and whatever you have a favor, it is from Allah. Then what adversity touches you, to him you cry for help. You know, something happens, they ask to Allah. Then when he removes adversity from you, at once a party of you associate others with their Lord. Ayah number 55, so they will deny what we have given them. Then enjoy yourself, for you are going to know. Ayah number 56 onwards, and they assign to what they do not know a portion of that which we have provided them by Allah. You will surely be questioned about what you used to invent. Means doing the shirk. Shirk is zulmun azim. And you have to ask forgiveness in this world. And they attribute to Allah daughters. Exalted is he, for them is what they desire. In ayah number 57, they are assigning daughters as Allah, like daughters to Allah. They themselves don't like daughters. And the one of them is informed of the birth of a female, his face becomes dark. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, your face becomes dark when you have a girl child, and he suppress grief. they don't share the news of daughter. And in olden days and right now also, many female fetus, they just make them dead, whether they find out what is the gender, and then they do it, like especially for the females. And in olden days and right now also, many countries, may Allah save us all, this is kind of ignorance and jahalia. He hides himself from the people because of the ill of which he has been. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, what he has been informed, should he keep in humiliation or bury in the ground? Unquestionable evil is what they decided. So inshallah, after the class I can answer the question. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not dislike daughters, do not dislike them. Some people, they give preference to their sons over their daughters, even in treatment. In a hadith we learn that whoever has a female child and he does not kill her, that does not disrespect her, yani he does not treat her poorly and does not favor his son over her, then Allah will make him enter Jannah. So daughters are liked and loved. One should give respect and liked. For those who do not believe in hereafter is the description of evil. And for Allah is the highest attribute and he is exalted in might and wise. Ayah number 61, we are doing Suratul Nahl. And if Allah were to impose blame on the people for their wrongdoing, he would not left upon the earth any creature, but he defers them for a specified term. And when their term has come, they will not remain behind an hour, nor will they precede it. If Allah wants to catch the people, if they are doing oppression and doing the zulm, no single person will be on the earth. And we see that people were punished for the wrong what they do in the world. The creation, not a single creature would remain alive on the earth if Allah were to give the punishment. We see that a man once said that indeed the oppressor only harms himself. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, this is wrong. A bird in the nest dies because of the oppression of the oppressor, meaning the effect of injustice are far reaching. They go beyond the oppressor. So there are many who are sufferer because of zulm. And this is why we should keep seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayah number 62, and they attribute to Allah that which they dislike, and their tongue assert the lie. They will have the best from him. Assuredly, they will have the fire. They will therein neglected. Ayah number 63, and by Allah, we did certainly send messengers to nation before you, but shaitan made their deeds attractive to them. But he is the disbeliever, Ali today, as well as they will have a painful punishment. Sometimes people who are close to you, they behave like a shaitan. They try to whisper you for the wrong things. You want to do good, but they whisper you to do the wrong thing. And they make the things so adorning and you get carried away. Especially young age is so difficult to control. It's not easy though. But inshallah, you can. When you are steadfast, you can. And we have not revealed to you the book except for you to make clear to them and where they have differed as a guidance and mercy for the people who believe. Ayah number 65, and Allah has sent down rain from the sky and given life there by the earth after its lifelessness. Indeed, in that a sign for the people who listen. There and then, again and again, water has been mentioned because everything depends on the rain. Ayah number 66, indeed for you in grazing livestock is a lesson. We give you drink from what in their bellies between excretion and blood, pure milk palatable to drink. So amazing, isn't it? When you look at the cow or the goat, the milk they give, such a white and delicious, that's what it's talking about, amazing, the udder, it's all fat, flesh, blood, and yet there is a milk coming out, and that milk is white and it's coming out from the cow, and inside of the cow there is so much other stuff. There is no traces of that excretions of anything, like you see blood is there and other things are so also there, but you see how the milk is so nice. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, I know nothing that suffices in place of food and drink except milk. So make it a habit to drink lot of milk. In hadith, we learned that three things are not to be returned. Pillow meaning a bedding, perfume and a milk. So we also learned that whoever gives a gift of silver or gold or gives milk to someone to drink, then it is though he set a slave free. It's so liked, you know, and like the gift of the milk, that's what it means. And sometimes if you can't drink particular type of, then you can change the, you know, sometimes you can have the almond, but the cow and the those milk is said about the, maybe if you can't have the milk, you can have yogurt in that replacement, because it is made out of milk only. Yogurt, cheese, that also you can replace it. But have good things, you know, because it's mentioned in the Quran. And from the fruits of the palm trees and grape vines, you take intoxicant and good provision. Indeed, is that a sign for the people who reason? Ayah number 68. Wa uha rabbuka ila nahl. Now, in ayah number 68, the name of Nahl is mentioned. Nahl means honeybee. And your Lord inspired to the bee. Meaning, Allah is the one who trained the honeybee. And what did the honeybee do? It's working away, so obedient. What is the command? But Allah gave to the bee, take for yourself among the mountains, houses, meaning make your house where? Somewhere up in the mountain, and also among the trees and in that which they construct, meaning in the buildings that people make. So first have should be at right place, you know, they select the right place, clean, and your Lord is inspired. And then eat from all fruits and follow the ways of your Lord and laid down for you. So we see that the honeybee does not fly at random. You know, if you read about it in very particular way. So its flight is also determined by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There emerges from their bellies a drink varying in colors. Have you noticed honey, the natural honey is in different colors, in which there is healing for the people. Honey is healing power. Indeed, in that is a sign for the people who gives thought. So amazing, isn't it? Such a tiny, it is like honeybee, and it has so many benefits. Does amazing work which is only possible at the inspiration of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So honeybee is doing so many things that is mentioned over here. So what it does, we learn that honeybee must gather nectar from 2 million flowers to make 1 pound of honey. And one bee has to fly about 90,000 miles, which is basically the distance of 3 times around the globe to make 1 pound of honey. But the average bee will only make around 1/12 of a teaspoon of honey in its lifetime. Just think about that, 1/12 of a teaspoon, that the honey that one bee will make in the entire life. It visits 50 to 100 flowers during a collection trip. And yani it can fly so far, subhanallah, such a tiny creature working so hard and making all of this honey. Why, you see that bees actually make more honey than they need. And this shows us that they make honey for who? For us. In it is healing for people. Fihi shifau linnas. Ibn al-Qayyim said, honey is food. It is medication. It is a drink. It is sweet dessert. It is ointment. It is delightful. We learn in hadith, healing is in three things. Drinking honey, the glass of the cupper, and meaning cupping, and cauterizing with fire, which is forbidden, cauterizing. Indeed, in that is a sign for the people who give thought. From honeybee, from its work, we learn in hadith that the believer is like a honeybee, that it does not eat anything except what is good, and it does not produce anything except what is good, and it is also very careful. Like, you know, we should be good towards us and towards others also. Meaning when it eats, when it takes, you know, for example, pollen or nectar or whatever that it eats from flowers, when it lands, it does not break the flower and it does not ruin it in any way. So there is a lot to learn from honeybee, and such an organized way she makes the honey. It has so much details I can't cover in Dore Quran. Inshallah, when we do the tafsir detail, like all the year we do the detail tafsir, inshallah, in those classes you can inshallah come and join us. So here mention about honeybee, and you know, try to have first thing in the morning honey with the warm water. It really helps you, and that's what I do. But the time I learn about honey, it's beneficial for you. You can get the honey and have first thing in the morning, and Allah created you, then he will take you in death, and among you is he who is reversed, is the most old age, so that he will not know. After having had knowledge a thing, indeed Allah is knowing and competent. So ayah number 71, and Allah has favored some of you over others in provision. Some has more, some has less, you know. Those who were favored would not hand over their provision to those whom their right hand possessed, so they would be equal to them. Then is the favor of Allah they reject. Ayah number 72 onwards. Here it is mentioned, and Allah has made for you from yourself male, and has made for you from your mate sons, then grandchildren, and has provided for you from the good things. Then in falsehood do they believe, in favor of Allah they disbelieve. Ayah number 73 onwards, they worship besides Allah that which does not possess for them the power, provision from the heaven and the earth at all. In fact, they are unable. So do not assert similarities to Allah. Indeed, Allah knows, you do not know. Ayah number 75, Suratul Nahl, Allah presents an example. A slave who is owned and unable to do a thing, and he to whom we have provided from us good provision. So he spends from it sincerely, he spends from it secretly and publicly. Can they be equal praise to Allah? But most of them do not know. Ayah number 76. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining with the example, metaphor. And Allah present an example of two men. One of them mute and unable to do a thing, while he is burdened to his guardian. Wherever he directs him, he brings no good. Is he equal to command justice while he is on the straight path? Ayah number 77. And to Allah belongs the unseen aspects of the heaven and the earth, and the commands for the hour is not but as a glance of the eye or even near. Indeed, Allah is over all things competent. Ayah number 78, and Allah has extracted you from the wombs of your mothers, not knowing a thing, and he made for you hearing and vision and intellect, that perhaps you would be grateful. Ayah number 79, do they not see the birds control in the atmosphere of the sky? None holds them up except Allah. Indeed, in that are signs for the people who believe. There is a hadith, Abu Zar radiallahu anhu said, we left Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam while not a bird would fly in the sky, except that he would mention something to us of knowledge regarding it, meaning there was a reflection and there was something to learn. So contemplate, don't just overlook. You know, when you look at the birds, that time also try to contemplate. That's what it means. And Allah has made for you from your homes a place to rest. Alhamdulillah, we have home to rest. And made for you from the hides of the animals, tents, which you find light on your day of travel or your day of encampment. Means when you go for camping, that's what it means. And ayah number 81. And Allah has made for you from that which he has created shadow, and made for you from the mountains shelter, has made for you garments which protect you from the heat, and the garment which protect you from your enemy battle. He complete his favor upon you that you might submit. Again talking about different name of blessings. But if they turn away, you know, after having all this blessing, then only upon you is responsibility for clear notification. So again, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been consoled. Your duty is to just convey the message. Let them do what they want to. Like alayka balagul mubin. So we have to convey the message. That is the sunnah. They recognize the favor of Allah when they deny it, and the most of them are disbelievers. Ayah number 84 onwards. And mention the day when we will resurrect from every nation a witness, then it will not be permitted to the disbelievers to apologize or make excuses, nor will they be asked to appease. I number 85-86, when those who wrong see the punishment, it will not be lightened for them, nor will they be reprieved. I number 86 and 87, and when those who associate others with Allah, they again and again is mentioned about associating partners not to do the shirk. See their partners, they will say, our Lord, these are our partners to you, whom we used to invoke besides Allah. But they will throw at them in the statement, indeed, you are liars. You know, they are making partners, but those partners they will deny in the hereafter, and they will impart to Allah, and that day their submission and lost from them is what they used to invent. Ayah number 88, those who disbelieve and averted others from the way of Allah, we will increase them in punishment over their punishment for what corruption they were causing. Ayah number 89 and 90, and mention the day when we will resurrect among every nation a witness over them from themselves, and we will bring you a witness over your nation, and we will send down to you a book as clarification for all things and guidance, mercy and tidings for the Muslim. Ayah number 90, here mention, indeed Allah ordered justice and good conduct and giving to the relatives, and bad conduct and oppression, He admonishes you that perhaps you will be reminded. Ayah number 91 onwards, and fulfill the covenant of Allah when you have taken it, and do not break oath after their confirmation, while you have made Allah over you witness. Indeed, Allah knows what you do. Ayah number 92, Suratul Nahl, and do not be like the woman who untwisted her spun thread after it was strong, taking your oath as means of deceit between you, because one community is more plentiful in number of wealth than another community. Allah only tries you thereby, and He will surely make clear to you on the day of resurrection. Ayah number 93 and 94, inshallah we will end soon. And if Allah had will, He could have made you one religion, but He causes to astray whom He wills and guides whom He wills. You will surely be questioned about what you used to do. We have given the time span, and we have to tell what we have done in this world. And do not take your oath as a means of deceit between you, and lest a foot slip after it was once firm, and you would taste evil in the world for what people used to divert it from the way of Allah, and you would have in hereafter greater punishment. Some people, they have habitually promise this thing, that thing. Don't start saying, you know, swearing, and do not exchange the covenant of Allah for small price. Indeed, what is with Allah is best for you, if only you could know. And here mention in ayah number 96, whatever you have will end, but what Allah has is lasting, and we will surely give those who were patient their reward according to the best of what they used to do. Everything ends, but what Allah has doesn't end. Whoever does righteousness, whether male or female, while he is a believer, does not matter whether you are male or female, as far as you are a believer, we will surely cause him to live a good life, and we will surely give them their reward in the hereafter according to the best of what they used to do. Ayah number 98, فَإِذَا قَرَتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. So when you recite the Quran, seek refuge with Allah from Shaitan the outcast. So whenever we do the recitation, what we say, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ, because Shaitan will be on the alert mode. Indeed, there is for him no authority over those who believed and rely upon their Lord. And ayah number 100, his authority is only over those who take him as an ally, those who through him associates other than Allah. Ayah number 101, and when we substitute a verse in the place of a verse, and Allah is most knowing of what he sends down, they say, you are but an inventor of lies, but most of them do not know. Ayah number 102, say, pure spirit has brought it down from your Lord, Angel Jibril, in truth to make firm those who believe and guidance and good tidings to the Muslim. The Quran is Ruh. It is the food for the Ruh, and the angel who has brought it is, it is also Ruhul Quddus, Angel Jibreel. Ayah number 103, and we certainly know that they say it is only a human being who teaches prophet, like, you know, they are saying how come a prophet can be a human being. The tongue of the one who they refer to, it's foreign, and this Quran in clear Arabic language. Indeed, those who do not believe in the ayah of Allah, Allah will not guide them. For them is a painful punishment. Ayah number 105. The only invent falsehood who do not believe in the verse of Allah, and it is those who are the liars. Ayah number 106. Whoever disbelieve in Allah after his belief, except for the one who is forced to renounce his religion while his heart is secure in the faith. Like, you know, sometimes people, they caught you and they forcefully asking to say you are not Muslim. But Allah knows in your heart you are a Muslim. You understand? Just to save your life, you are saying you are not. But those willing upon their chest to disbelieve, upon them is a wrath from Allah, and for them is a great punishment. And ayah number 107, that is because they prefer the worldly life over the hereafter, and that Allah does not guide the disbelieving people. And in this, Abdullah ibn Mubarak said, how many a great deed is reduced to nothing because of ill intention. So our intention should be pure and good. Those are the one over whose heart and hearing vision Allah has sealed. It is those who are heedless. Assuredly, it is they in hereafter who will be the losers. And then Allah says, then indeed your Lord to those who emigrated after they had been compelled, on the day when every soul will come out disputing for itself. Every soul will be fully compensated for what it did, and they will not be wrong. So whatever we are doing, Allah knows about it. It will be written. It's not like, you know, in this world we work for so many hours, but our taxes are cut off, right? And Allah presents an example of a city which was safe and secure. It provisioned coming in abundance from every location, but it denied the favors of Allah. So Allah made it taste the envelopment, the clothing of hunger and fear for what they had been doing. If somebody is doing wrong, Allah will punish them. And there had certainly come to them messenger from among themselves, but they denied him. So punishment overtook them while they were wrongdoing. You know, when messenger is sent, if they don't listen, then definitely punishment. Then eat of what Allah has provided for you, in which is lawful and good, and be grateful for the favors of Allah. It is indeed him that you worship. Ayah number 115, he has only forbidden to you dead animals, blood, flesh of a swine, that which has been dedicated to other than Allah. But whoever is forced by necessity, neither desiring it nor transgressing it, its limit, then indeed Allah is forgiving and merciful. Here, look at the ayah number 115. These four things, like you are not supposed to eat dead animal, blood or flesh of a swine, and other than Allah, if they do sacrifice. But many people, they think, okay, we can eat anywhere because we can eat Ahlul Kitab. Yeah, you can, but it should be kosher. It should be halal. Are they doing the same way that when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was there, they used to do the halal, even the Jews and Christians. But it's not right now. So you can't eat anywhere and whatever you like. You should eat the halal food because that is light. And whatever you eat, it will affect on your nature. And ayah number 116 onwards, and do not say about what your own tongues put forth falsely, this is lawful and this is forbidden, so that you invent a lie against Allah. Indeed, those who invent lie against Allah will not prosper. And ayah number 117 to 119, a brief enjoyment will be there. They will have a painful punishment. And to those who are Jews, we have forbidden, which we have mentioned to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, before. And we wrong them not, but they used to wrong themselves. Then indeed, your Lord, for those who do evil in ignorance, then repent. You know, by mistake, you didn't have the knowledge and you did the wrong. Then you repent, you did the tawbah after that. And do righteous deeds. Indeed, your Lord thereafter is of forgiving and most merciful. Like, you know, ignorantly sometimes it happens, you do, but you amend your things. Indeed, Ibrahim al-Islam was a whole community by himself, obedient to Allah, exclusively devoted, and he was not of those who associate others with Allah. Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitatan and lillahi hanifa wa lam yakum minash shakirin. Thankful for his bounties, he, Allah, chose him and his guide to him a straight path. And we gave him good in the world and certainly in the hereafter. And he shall be among the righteous when we inspired you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying, follow the religion of Ibrahim al-Islam, exclusively devoted, and he was not of those who associate others with Allah. Ayah number 124 and 125. Very soon, inshallah, will end. At 128 will stop, inshallah. The sabt was only prescribed for those who differed in it, and indeed your Lord will judge between them on the day of resurrection about what they used to differ. Call Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the way of your Lord with wisdom and good instruction and argue with them in a way that is better. Indeed your Lord knows best of him who has given astray from his way, and he is the best aware of those who are guided. And if you punish, then punish with the like of that, you know, don't punish more than that. You were afflicted, and if you endure patiently like you do sabr, that is indeed best for those who are patient. You can take retribution, but equivalent, you can't take more. But if you do sabr and forgive and forget, that's better. Endure your patiently, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and your patience is not but from Allah, and grieve not over them, and be not in distress because of what they plot. You know, they were plotting and planning against Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah is consoling his heart. Okay, don't worry about that. Inna Allaha ma'al lazina taqaw wal lazina hum muhsinun. Indeed, Allah is with those who fear him and those who do good. Alhamdulillah, here, you know, we finished our juz number 14, and inshallah in juz 15 we'll start new surah inshallah tomorrow. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.